All right, so it's December 20th, 5:15 p.m. I keep making these videos. I know it's like super close to Christmas, and everybody's getting in their Christmas spirit, and so I don't, if you're watching, if you're doing your Christmas thing, do your Christmas thing. This is just for me, so 2018, 2018 will be a little different. So, been thinking how I want to break this up. I've been talking about the setting of these last 10 years or whatever. This last kind of the climate in my life, and well, not just in general. But actually, I do want to talk about, get into more specifics on my life. Last thing I did say was about aliens. Okay, so, obviously, in the Bible, they do talk about angels and stuff like that. So that's what I believe. Aliens are. I don't know. I mean, who knows? I really don't know about. I've never personally experienced aliens. Like, I don't know. No, I've never been visited. I've never been. No aliens in dreams. I did have a dream that there was this big, like, war where they. It's kind of like, that one Tom Cruise movie where they come. The aliens, what the heck is that movie called? It's like a Steven Spielberg movie. But anyway, it was kind of like that where you're looking out the window and like these big old, these space, or I don't know if they were spaceships, but it was just like explosion bombs, and it was like what you would think of if aliens were attacking the world and taking over and destroying everything, and you're in it, and it was like grenades, and it was crazy. It was like, it was one of those dreams that I was like, whoa, that was better than any, that was crazier than any movie or anything that I've ever experienced. It was like real life, and one of those really long dreams that were like, that lasted hours, felt like hours, and like a day, could have been 2 days worth of in my dream. And I will get into dreams a little bit more, but right now I want to get into some factual stuff. And I will get into, there's a thing, not aliens, but there's a thing where, I forget what they call it, where these things visit, or like, where you think we're kind of sleeping, but then not sleeping, and then you see some things, and then you wake up and you're like, whoa, and you couldn't move and stuff. Sleep paralysis. Excuse me. So sleep paralysis is something I do want to talk about, and that did happen to me, and I think people kind of put that into the alien thing, which I don't know, maybe, but that means it's like Men in Black, where aliens are living amongst us or whatever. Which I do have some theories on sleep paralysis and what that might be. In scientific terms and in spiritual terms, the theories that I have for that. But so this is on my mind. This is heavy on my mind. It's been something I've been wanting to talk about for a long time. And I know there's too many. Like, I've been like, man, I'm like, okay, I want to talk about this. I want to talk about that. I want, and I'm trying to be positive. I really am trying to be positive for those of you that are watching this, like, definitely be positive. But there's also time, and I've been positive. That's the thing, is I've been positive, and maybe that's why I've gotten through. But I'm still not happy with where I'm at. And people believing something that's not true about me. And I can't really just go beat everybody up, because I really do feel like beating people up, just because people are really disrespectful. And these people that are disrespectful, you know, they must believe something else, because, or you know, whatever they believe, you know, they're not, nobody, like I said, asked me. So instead of, you know, confronting every person that feels like they want to be disrespectful, it got into a level where it's crazy. So, you know, like Muhammad Ali, I've taken the punches, and, you know, and it's my turn to give a few. And also, you know, I really feel it's not just this bombardment of what people believe of my past and my life and my past and things that are in my life. You know, people added a lot more stuff, more crazy stuff, and whatever their reasons are, whatever they want to, like, add stuff so that, you know, that to whatever, make my life miserable because of my past or whatever, you know, trying to see who I am or whatever. The stuff that they added is way more worse than anything that I've done. So they should be held accountable. You know, they're down, you know, we live in a lot. I just looked at some Facebook stuff, and like, they did, you know, these people in government are just doing whatever they want. Like, you know, they're just filling up their pockets, and nobody has any say so. You know, I'm Mexican, I'm not a white person. I just saw this other thing too, where they were like, oh, Jewish people think they're white, and, you know, and then the white guy's like, oh yeah, don't act like you're white, and the Jewish dude's like, oh, well, I am white, and what did he say? He was like, oh, I don't talk to my wife's family member, or there's my wife's mom anymore, because she voted for Trump. And first, you know, that's how they started in World War II, was like, they always come for the Jews after, you know. And so there's all this stuff, like, so pretty much it's kind of like a lawless country right now. People are just doing really whatever they want. And I know there's like, there's still, the system's still going, there's still like progressing, everything's still happening, you know. Everybody's buying stuff for Christmas, everybody's doing all the normal stuff, and, you know, so it's still functioning. But the dude over, the mayor in San Francisco, just had a heart attack or something, and Walmart or whatever, I don't know. Not to be disrespectful to him and his family, but, you know, it's kind of crazy, you know, like, these people that are just dying here and there. So that's how I feel about my conspiracy theories about, you know, United States right now and the world. You know, I know, like, you know, all these fires going on. It's hard to figure out which ones are fake and which ones are real. So the fires, you know, it's like, wow, you know, like, is that possible? Like, for that many fires to be happening? Like, and whose houses are getting burnt? You know, like, who's... It's kind of like the anthrax stuff during 9/11. Like, my theories are, you know, those are sent to prominent people for scare tactics by our own government. So that's where, I know it sounds crazy, but people that follow that stuff is like, I don't know, Eminem, like, poor Eminem, like, he started talking about the government, and that guy just, his career went all the way down. Same thing with Dixie Chicks. So, you know, like, the government's very powerful, and they have to slap artists around to make sure they stay in place and don't get too huffy puffy. Which I feel happened to me. You know, people went into my past and, you know, threw all this stuff at me and said, but they did it in a way where it wasn't really trying to figure out what was going on. You know, they were really trying to add stuff to bury me more than trying to, you know, put it through the justice system. So, like I said, lawless, there's no justice system for certain people. You know, there's people that are just go outside the law, you know, whether it's killing people to silence them or to, you know, do what they've done to me so far. And I guess they did it to the Black Panthers, you know, and other people, you know, infiltrate and do the FBI thing, and they infiltrate like groups and, you know, set up fake relationships and do all kinds of stuff. So this is all new to me. Like, you know, you can read it in a book, and but when you actually live it and like see it, it gets a little crazier. And you know, there's people that are just like in the middle that don't really know what's going on, or, you know, they're just hired to do whatever they, you know, their job is, to protect their community or protect their, you know, whatever, and protect their all that patriotic duty, which I think a lot of the military people that come back are part of that. They call it Black Ops or whatever. So that was like in the Punisher movie, you know, like these people. So I don't know. I have no real knowledge of that particular branch of society, other than being a victim of this stuff. So I'm gonna go through a couple of these. So some of the stuff that I've seen or whatever was, like I said, there's so many of them. So, okay, so supposedly I'm a rapist, I'm a murderer, I'm a child molester, I'm gay. What else? There's plenty of other ones, I'm sure. So, you know what I mean? Like, how do you respond to that when... Okay, so let me start off with this one. This is stuff that you can, like, Google and get into the... probably see, you know, in the newspaper stuff. So there's this one guy that got busted in Chico for kidnapping women, I think. I don't know if it was a group. This is stuff. I was living in Cohasset at the time, I think. I don't know where I was living. I was either living with my son's mom's family in Paradise, or I was teaching at Butte living. I had given up 42 Oak Drive, where I had lived for there for a bunch of years, and I was like getting rid of all my stuff and renting. I started renting like rooms and stuff. Like, and I'll go through the, you know, this is when I started running into people that were fake kind of situations. So this guy, I guess, like, worked at a hospital, and he would, he got busted in his truck. He had this, I don't know, big truck or something, and he had, like, some stuff where he was able to tie up people and put, like, knock them out, you know, with like, certain, I guess, like, hospital, anesthesia or whatever, stuff that makes you forget or whatever. I don't know exactly what that, but something like that. And it's funny because I saw somebody in Martin Hill like having that, like she was acting like she was practicing for her exam. So anyway, I was doing an open mic or whatever. So this guy gets busted for that, right? And the cop like, oh yeah, you know, I guess it was a string of these things happening where women would wake up, would in Chico. And Chico is a college town, a party town. So there's like a lot of women, and you know, I guess like Playboy went through there, Snoop Dogg went through there, like doing Girls Gone Wild and like all this stuff. So there's, it's a hot spot, you know, for stuff. You know. So this guy gets busted. I don't know. I guess I learned he was from Orville. And the reason that, you know, I know people, so there's a family member that's a family member, and she worked at the hospital, and so she knew the guy, and so she would say stuff on Facebook. And so I'm reading all this stuff, and like, so this guy was supposed to be like a father. He's a father, or a family guy, and you know, white dude, supposedly good looking or whatever. And like, so the dude gets busted with all this stuff, and the cops pull him over. And I guess before that, there was these girls that would wake up not knowing like where they are and stuff like that. And then some, I guess, even like ran, got away from the car, you know. So they would go home, and I guess at night after the bar, because I guess everybody walks from, it's a college town, so people were able to, there's like a downtown with all the bars, and then everybody can walk to where all the college kids live. And so I guess like, you know, some girls would, I don't know. I there was, you know, they're on the news, on the Facebook news or whatever. So they're like, you know, one girl, I guess, got away from the car. And I guess they were black cars. I don't know what kind of cars they were. They must have been nice. I guess in my mind, they were like, probably like nice cars or whatever. Like something that would fit in. They weren't like gangster. It didn't sound like they were like some gangsters or whatever. I don't know. Anyway, so my theory on that, you know, is probably happened. You know, like, I don't, you know, there's a lot worse things, not just worse, but there's a lot of stuff happening, happens, where trafficking, human trafficking. So, you know, and then you got the porn stuff going on. So, and I didn't realize this, but Sacramento is like a big, is also a hub. You know, it's pretty close to Butte County. And there's like a military base and all that. So, you know, it's in the military. There's all kinds of stuff going on. So for this to happen sounds like very possible and probably likely. I mean, where does prostitution not happen? So people getting crazy to, you know, getting women that are really beautiful and taking advantage of them, you know, when it's easy pickings. But my theory is, how are you going to, no matter if they're drunk, usually people travel in packs to begin with, but like, no matter if they're drunk, like, they can fight off somebody or whatever, you know. If you're a woman, you should know that, you know, you got to be able to protect yourself when you're out there. You know, as a man, like, you know, we feel we can, you know, handle ourselves, or, you know, in that kind of situation. If somebody tries to kidnap us, you know, we can most likely fend off somebody. But for women, you know, they grow up knowing, you know, that's something you teach a woman for the rest, from the beginning, is, you know, you gotta carry some mace or something. So that happened. That guy got busted, worked for the hospital, did it, you know, supposedly he was the guy that did it. I don't know, you know, there's investigations, I'm sure, that are ongoing investigations, obviously. So that guy, I believe he's not, didn't work alone. How do you, maybe one guy do all that stuff? Like, How are you gonna knock somebody out, like all secret, like with your by yourself, like running around by yourself, and like, you know. So yeah, so I don't know if he was a scapegoat or whatever. Anyway, so people, I think, no one ever said anything. I think they thought of, I was part of this thing happening, 'cause like I said, their fear of like some people, and like it was weird. I was just like, what the fuck? So I don't know how my name, how, if that's anything to do with anything. Obviously, you know, I don't have stuff, so I don't have access to that stuff. So I don't know if, but I did have some run-ins with people in the hospital, like that worked for, that had ties to the owners of the hospital. I'll get into that later. And I've said it publicly, I've said it, you know, to people, and you know, with me being recorded here and there, I'm sure they have all this stuff, like, you know, documented, and they know my belief and story about that. So yeah, so I'm just saying this for the normal people, like the authorities and everything probably know. I already said this stuff already. This is just stuff that, you know, as I've been trying to figure out what the hell people were talking about, this is one of the things that I thought was part of that. So just in case anybody thinks anything like that, like, no, I was never dude knocking people out or doing that. Period. So, you know, if you have a question about that, you can ask me. If I know you, if I, you know, meet you or whatever, you know, just crush that rumor out and let's move on. Okay, so another one was, okay, so this one's bad too. All these are bad. That's why it's like having me even talk about them is like, it takes so much effort and so much, like, I have so much built up anger that, yeah, I have to say it. So, okay, so the other one, similar, and this is where it gets crazy. Like, I don't know, like I said, if it's the authorities were fucking with me or whoever was fucking with me, somebody that had access to hacking into my phone, hacking into my stuff. So one of the things was, I'd go see my son in Paradise, right? Like, this is already when he was already 13, 14, 15, I don't know. So he was already, his mom and him were doing their own thing. She broke up with her ex-husband or whatever. So I'd go drive from Chico to Paradise, you know, or Cohasset to Paradise, whatever, just go say hi to him, and I can go spend time with them or whatever. And one of them was, so yeah, dude, like, okay, so this is so fucked up. So every time I'd drive over there and then I'd drive back, like there was like some shit on Facebook or something that'd be like, oh yeah, this kid almost got kidnapped or stuff like that. The ones that I know about, you know, I've seen them on, like I said, Facebook, and I'm like, the fuck? That was like the same time that I was driving through there, or you know, through like in Paradise. Like, the fuck? Like, you know, after one time and two times and three times, that's like happening, you know? I'm like, okay, that's fucking weird. Like, people trying to set, like, saying shit, like, because that had to do with also the people kidnapping women and stuff like that. So I'm like, oh man, these guys, like, fucking, this is already like what I'm already like, you know, after Butte College, this is like I already, you know, had to deal with all kinds of shit through Butte College, and so there's like, I'm already aware of all this stuff, man. I'm already like fucking living in the mountains next to fucking crazy ass fucking weed growers, and fucking everybody's shooting guns, and fucking, so I'm already just like done. I'm just like, dude, I don't know what the fuck. Like, so that is this little bit added thing right there. So I'm like, okay, so nobody can believe, like, I'm still here, like, has to be fake. Like, they know, cause so this kid got in trouble for, this is the one that was on the news, and it was like, so this kid gets in trouble for lying, like to catch him in a lie. He was like, "Oh yeah, somebody tried to kidnap me and I got away," and then he starts crying or something like that, and he's like, "Oh, okay, I made it up." And the moms, and these are like paradise people, so, and you know, like poor white people, and you know, like trailer park people. I don't know, like, I don't know. I didn't know all. I didn't see that. Like that one lady was on the news, so. And there was like there is a lot of small town stuff, you know, camaraderie, and like I've never, you know, through this, you know, what I'm gonna tell you, all this stuff, like there is like, you know, little conspiracy people getting together and like doing shit like this. So yeah, so that happened. I don't know if I was on that radar, if I was the one that was like, but the reason I even mention this is because when I moved over here to the Bay Area 2 years ago, I noticed people were like tripping on like where I was driving, if I was driving by schools and shit. So I guess supposedly the Pokemon thing, or I guess, and this is why, you know, I want to start suing motherfuckers, or, you know. They got me on a fucking, I don't know because no one said nothing, but it, you know, it's pretty clear that, or, you know, insinuated that, you know, that I'm on a list. And this is part of the intimidation, part of the, you know, there's, like I said, there's stuff from my past that people pulled through. I'm gonna go through that. But for to have me like on a list of like pedophiles and fucking stealing people, stealing kids and shit like that is the worst, and they've done the worst. That's why I say, you know, when they took shit from me, they took everything. They took, tried to take everything. They, you know, if I was a weaker person, I would, you know, have gave up somehow. You know, they were always like, "Oh, I wonder if he's gonna be suicidal," and blah blah blah. No, I'm not. You know, kind of like Tupac. You know, if I can't go out in the world, can't go, can't die yet because can't have people believe this shit. So that's one of the things. Like, so this is my own words, you know, to the public. You know, if you're checking this out, if you've been hearing those rumors, this is my only defense. You know, I've told people plenty of times. Obviously, they still believe that shit, or they're still using it and still trying to have power over me, you know, subjugate me, demoralize me, keep me quiet, you know, neutralize me. And this is game warfare that's been going on, mental warfare that, you know, the FBI and the CIA has been using on activists forever. You know, I mean, they assassinate people. So, you know, this is just another type of assassination. And I wish I could be positive about all this stuff. I wish I could be like, "Yay, you know, everything's great. I'm still alive. It's wonderful." But, you know, with anybody thinking that of me, you know, is the worst. You know, and especially if my son thinks of this stuff. Like, and I'm gonna go through that too because I don't know. Everybody's playing games, which is fine. But like I said, you know, if I can, if anybody had real things against me, like we should have just went to court of law. Like, and I said, 10 years, I can't wait anymore for people to let me free, to set me free, to let other people set me free, because I've already waited 9 years with letting people videotape me and fucking infiltrate me and check out my phone and all this shit. And, you know, you've been used as a scapegoat for other people, you know, and in the history of America, how they treat people like me, like people that are outspoken and could have influence, potential influence. Is not good. You know, there's no rules. These people You know, and for the authorities that are watching this, it's like, dude, you know, you're a human being. I'm a human being, like, and I'm not guilty of all, you know, like I said, there's a court of law. Like, we can go there. Like, for the stuff that I'm mentioning and stuff, whether I'm right or wrong about it, like, it affected me. It affected my community. It affected my family. It affected the minds of everyone that I know. And, you know, and then it gets worse. You know, people feel like they can throw stones and get involved and feel they want to be heroes and they can, like, throw some fucking little stupid shit at me. You know, so people are throwing shit at me. I'm in a cage. Fucking people are adding shit all over. Fucking. So it's just, like, mentally fucking abusive and a setup. And that's why I'm pointing fingers back to the authorities and the communities and the racists and the fucking KKK and the fucking drug dealers and the fucking, you know, fucking all these people that want to be do-gooders that are on Facebook that want to be like, oh yeah, say their funny things. Everyone that's been involved, Hollywood, you know, fucking nobody wants to clean up their own mess, but they sure can throw some shit. So everyone that's been throwing shit at me for 9 years and stuff, you know, I've taken it, and I knew where, I didn't know where it was coming from, but, you know, I knew all these lies were happening. So that's why I'm making these videos, for the people that actually do know me, you know, or, you know, people that care for me, people that are maybe confused about some of this stuff, that actually maybe, you know, we knew each other and we don't know each other now, but you believe this stuff. And, you know, if it comes from the FBI, it comes from fucking authorities, of course, you know. I personally wouldn't believe it until, like, you know, people have been trying to say stuff about other people and I, you know, to get me to also be part of that kind of fucking circus throwing shit at people. But I, you know, I know how these things work, you know, trying to break people up and fight against each other and, you know, fear. Like Bill Cosby, I don't know. Bill Cosby, I'm not gonna say yay or nay. Like, he can go to court of law and figure it out. I don't know. That's none of my business. You know, same thing with Weinstein. I don't know. Fucking, like, how do people not know about this shit already? You know, and I appreciate, you know, the media giving me a little outlet to speak my voice about, you know, some of these issues. But yeah, so that's stuff that's happening. Okay, so that pissed me off. Be on a list and over here, you know, being followed and people, you know, feeling they have an open door to put their feces on, you know, which is what they've done. But, you know, who has a, I don't have an easy life, but I know my greatness. So the more powerful I am, the more powerful my enemies are going to be. And so, you know, I'm not fighting some normal, again, bullies. This is actually real shit. So, you know, that's why I think it's, you know, and it could be military. Who knows? I could have pissed off some rich person, which, you know, some people think it's this or that, but who knows? You know, I know, you know, there's a lot of secret shit happening in America and how, you know, they're dealing with people like me, you know. Basically, I'm not alone, and if I'm not guilty of things, then it's not gonna demoralize me. You can have me run around naked on YouTube or whatever, and whatever, dude. Okay, sorry, this is crazy. How do you not get crazy about this stuff? Okay, so what is another one? Okay, so this one's bad too. And this is one of their doors that they opened so they can come at me. Let me see, do I want to go through something else before this? Okay, so Jared, right? The guy from Subway. So before that, and this was like early on too, like around 2009. I don't know where and when it was. The reason I know those dates is because when I left Daly City and to come back to Chico, I ended up getting a place with, and around 2008, 2009, I did shows, so I was already like out and about in Chico by 2009. So, you know, I was with this girl for a year or so in Chico, and then we broke up, and then I started going out and about in Chico, doing music and stuff like that. Before that, I was, you know, I had a girlfriend. She was more kind of like, you know, in some relationships, you guys just, you know, going out and about is not part of the relationship or whatever. Okay, so, oh yeah. So, so this has to do with porn, right? Okay, so porn. There, like I said, you know, it's not fun to talk about this publicly, especially, but this stuff's already out there. Like, seriously, like, I have family members, like, or people talking about, like, my sex life. And you know, this just seems to be a subject for people. So somehow, okay, so. My computer, okay, so I had the first computer was given to me by Fifth Son, and they gave me a computer to work on. That's the one I said I went to Daly City and worked on and had Photoshop and all these programs on it, and it was great, you know. I mean, it was an older computer, but it was still a good computer. It would last me for a long time. So I got back to Chico, working on this stuff, broke up with this girl. Been working on this computer for like, I was nonstop working. I mean, I'd go out and play music and hang out, like, not really hang out, but I'd go out and, like, you know, mingle with the locals or whatever, the artsy people, going and checking out shows. Okay, so yeah, okay, I won't go into the Chico scene, but, okay, so the first computer, had the first computer, used it, always left it on. Like, I don't know, I didn't really know all kinds about computers at that time. Like, I thought it was cool to just leave it on 24 hours a day. It lasted for a long time. Like, I used that, for, like, it was like a good computer, and like, you know, had a Wacom tablet, a big old Wacom. So I was, you know, all the stuff from Voice magazine, like, started using my skills to make my books and to finish my comics and all, you know, that was pretty much it. I hadn't gotten music or anything together yet. So, okay, so that was that. And then Dan Seward from Voice was like, and you know, it's weird because all these people know all this stuff, but I didn't know anything. You know, like, I was dealing with normal stuff, like, you know, going through a relationship, breaking up with somebody, being jealous, you know, trying to fix that up, paying my bills, doing like painting windows, painting like, you know, starting to do murals, you know, like doing all this normal stuff where, you know, barely paying the bills, you know, trying to raise my son, trying to be there for him, trying to, you know, help out, you know. And I was seeing women too. Those women that I was hanging out with, but I still really was heartbroken. You know, I tried to. When you go through a relationship with somebody, you sometimes they hurt you, sometimes you hurt them, sometimes you guys are competing who can hurt each other the most. So I was going through all that, you know, like, loved her. She loved me. You know, contrary to some of these funny people that feel like they're funny. So, But yeah, you know, we're both selfish. You know, I'm sure I loved her more, but there was definitely a shared. You know, we kept getting back together and whatever. So through this time, I was, you know, it was women being thrown at me. I'll put it like that. Like women were just like throwing themselves at me everywhere I went, and like women were just like, "Let's go, let's hang out." Let's, you know. And I've always had been that person where women usually, you know, come on to me. And you know, I'm kind of shy as an artist. Like, fuck, I'm still doing what I do. Like, still, like, sit around the house and create art. That's all I do. Like, you know, it's more intense now because I feel like I'm on, like, some battle. But, to save my art battle, to freaking finish this stuff so that people can stop trying to use it against me or whatever. So yeah, so that was